One-on-one radio show, and I am your host, Laima Hayes, and happy pre-Valentine's Day. Hey!
Yay!
And I have this lovely lady with me tonight. She's my special guest.
Belise Spivey, I'm in the house!
Hey! She in the house. And y'all know how we do it. This is Real Talk One-on-One, where we have, you know, real conversation, real people, real ideas, real problems, but come together with real solutions. So this is all about just, you know, talking about reality stuff. And today we're gonna have a special, special talk about, you know, just life itself. Belise is gonna talk about her ministry and what she does, and you know, give us some information and some input or some stuff that can help us in life. And so that's what Real Talk One-on-One Radio Show is all about. It's just talking, helping somebody, encourage someone, and this is my second night, so I'm happy for that. Yay for me.
Yeah.
And I know, you know, each Thursday is gonna get better and better and bigger and bigger. And don't forget to call in too if you have any questions or you have any remarks or whatever you want to talk about. If it, you know, concerning the show or whatever, the number is 404-355-8699. And if you're international, the number is 1-866-923-2860. Don't be afraid to call in. And so, Belise, let us tell me something, a little something about yourself.
So, first, I'm so excited to be here with you. We have a history.
Yes, we do.
We have a history. We were just talking about that. So, this is a blessing to see you grow. And doing something you've been probably hiding in your heart to do. So I'm really excited to say that you asked me to be a part of something that, I mean, you've been dreaming of, but also thank you for always being a part of what I've been doing. So I'm honored to be here and spending time with you. So my name is Belise Spivey. I'm known as the STD Life Coach. Yes, I said Sexual Transmitted Disease Life Coach or Sexual Infection, you know. So, you know, they want to change stuff. So we got to go with the trend. Disease is kind of harsh, you know, but that's what I do. I'm sure you're like, who is that? What is that? And why are you doing it? Number one, we don't have many. Many people are getting STDs. By the time you hit 25, you'll have one. Like, sadly to say, if you don't, ooh, you blessed. Like, because at the end of the day, sex is risky. We want to do it, but we don't understand what comes with it. And sadly to say, let's talk about it. Our brothers and sisters, we don't talk about it. We just say, don't do it. And my whole thing is, love God. He always tells us why not to do it. He tell you this is what I give you, and then it's what you do. And sadly to say, when it comes to church, they tell us one part, but they don't tell us the other. We're not following the way God did it. And that's where, I ain't gonna lie, that's why we're failing, because we're not following the way God taught us. So number one, let's be real. That's the reason why by the time you hit 25, it's bound. Wow. And it doesn't matter. You can be married. You can be single. It don't matter. You can kiss somebody and voila. And a lot of us don't think about it like that. It's like, well, I'm being celibate, you know. I'm doing everything right, I assume, you know. But without education, it's bound. And I think that's the biggest thing. It's not the act. It's the lack of. And as we know, you want to spit some scripture, we can do it all day, but at the end of the day, we all know it, but we don't understand how it can fail us in just this simple area. But like I was saying, I've been doing this for 4 years. I've been in it for 10 because I end up contracting herpes simplex virus type 2, genital herpes, when I was a sophomore in college. I was at Auburn University. I was like, I'm living my life. I'm living it up. And boom, it slapped me in my face. Like, I was like, oh my God, my life is over. You know, that's what we all think when we contract anything that's curable or uncurable. It doesn't really matter. You really do believe that people are not going to love you. You feel shame. You feel like, shoot, God, you really hate me. You know, like, why would you do this? But he was like, no, you did it to yourself, and you're just living out the consequences for it, but I'm going to restore you in the midst. And that's what he did to me. He used my boldness and my openness to talk about things to say, Belise, I'm going to give this to you as a thorn, but I'm going to help you free my children who are really in bondage. So I've been able to do that for the last 4 years on YouTube. So you can go to my YouTube channel, Belise Spivey, and I have over 300 and some videos on herpes plus other things. So I talk about that. I talk about my journey of being a mother, because I end up becoming a mother a year after that. So a single mom. So I get an STD and I turn around to be a mama. So it's like, okay, he double whamming me. Mm. Like, he double whamming me. But at the end of the day, he knew I was capable. He knew I was able. Right. He wanted me to grow up, and I did just that in the midst of that. So I became a mom after that. Shortly after that, about 5-6 years later, I ended up getting married. So yeah, I got blessed. He blessed me with a husband that I thought. Listen to your mama, y'all. Listen to your parents. They love y'all. I didn't listen, but I still was blessed in the midst. He really was supportive, and I will always honor him for supporting me in this journey. He supported me of go for it. If you want it, go for it. He supported me heavily, and I will always love him for that. So I end up starting this ministry right out of that relationship. I went in school, like I was getting my master's, so I ended up getting my master's in human services counseling. Yeah, man. I know, right? In life coaching. I was like, babe, I think I know what I want to do. And he was like, what? I said, I'm about to tell the world. He said, okay. He didn't realize it. He flipped up and went to sleep. And then when he woke up and he seen it on social media, reality set in because everybody thought I was dying. I was like, I'm not dying. It just hurt me. Jesus Christ. But that's the lack of knowledge. That's the lack of knowledge in it, where people believe just because it's not curable that you're dying. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people associate the fact that he has an H in it, you assume HIV off the top of your dome. Mm-hmm. And as we know now, just living in Atlanta, you don't have to die from it, y'all. Like, just take care of yourself and make sure you know your status, okay? So I've been doing it. I've been loving it. I've been able to literally change my own life, but also change the lives of so many people from across the globe. And I love what I do. I'm thankful that I laid down to do what I did. That's in a weird way, but I'm thankful that he chose me because he could have chose somebody else, but he chose me to say, you know, I know she gonna do it. Yeah. I know she gonna do it.
And that's, in matter of fact, that is very important, because when I met you, I think it was just the grace of God, because my own testimony, I contracted herpes. You know, I contracted herpes when I was 5 months, when I was pregnant with my daughter. I didn't know what it was. Did nobody teach me about herpes? You know, I was educated and nothing. Did nobody even teach me to wear a condom? And so,
tell the whole truth.
Yeah, I'm gonna tell the whole truth. Did nobody teach me nothing about sex or anything? You just did what you saw. You know, more is caught than taught.
Yeah.
You know, and my pastor says that, and that's so very true. Because when I contracted, I was scared. I was angry. I was like, oh, my goodness. I was pregnant. You know, I was pregnant at the same time. And so I'm dealing with herpes. Now I'm pregnant out of wedlock. You know?
Yeah.
And, you know what I'm saying? And that's like how do a person deal with that mentally? And so when I found you, I don't know. I can't even remember how I found your page or how we connected. But I was like, wow, it's somebody I can talk to that going through the same thing I'm going through is, and not ashamed of it.
Right.
You know,
I don't think I wasn't ashamed. I still dealt with some shame.
I just did it anyway. But you out there with it, like I had herpes, like with it on your chest.
Yeah, I got a shirt on now.
Exactly. Like promoting. I'm like, oh my goodness, I got to meet this young lady. And you was right where you had your first event at, you was right around the corner from my house.
Wow.
So I know it was like God ordained, because you weren't even that far from me, you know. And so I thank God for you been doing what you're doing, because it's helping a lot of women. It's not even women, but men too as well, because like you said, it's not something that you're going to die for. When people think of herpes, they'd be like, you know what I'm saying?
Well, they did HIV like that for so long. Yeah.
Not knowing that so many people have it.
80% of people have no clue.
Yeah.
Let me tell y'all something. I will have to bust bubbles today. If you see somebody with cold sore feverish, they got herpes, y'all. I'm so, like, I love people, but you ain't get that at birth. Like, some did. Oh, I had it since I was a child. You're right. Somebody kissed you. Yeah. Or you could have got it through the birth canal and your mom didn't know. Mm-hmm. Interestingly, most doctors, OBGYNs, don't test for herpes.
Nope.
Now they're starting to, because it's dangerous. Before, it was just like, you know, the baby probably had another issue. They didn't really understand it. But now we're living in a time where babies are getting taken out, you know, and we got to keep it real. We seeing a lot of stuff on social media bringing things to the surface. Mm-hmm. And when it bring it to the surface, it put heat. What? Thank you, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat. Thank y'all. Because at the end of the day, it's bringing awareness to things that people are dealing with in silence. Mm-hmm. But now Now the media said, well, they kept whiff. We got to do something. Mm-hmm. CDC don't play that. If we all talk about it, we got to do something. We can't just sit here and do nothing. Yeah. That's their job is always to make sure they keep things at bay. So at the end of the day, we have to understand if you see somebody with cold sores or fever blisters, they have herpes. No, not saying that they got it from sex. They could have got it from just simple kiss. Many people in different cultures, that's what they do. That's how they grade each other. All of us have been kissed by our moms and dads and all that stuff like that. You got that auntie who just like keep your mouth to yourself. But at the end of the day, we all have those. So I don't want you to assume just because you see somebody with it, they got it from sexual intercourse or anything like that. It may not have been that. But I do want us to educate. If you keep seeing a Breva, they talking about herpes. I don't want, I want to bust, you know, our community, you know, bubble. CarMax is not, it was for herpes, y'all. I love y'all, but I have to tell y'all this. You know why you keep putting it on your lips? It's because it's supposed to dry it out. It's medicated. I got to tell y'all that because I see so many people put it on and you wonder why you put it on all day. Because it's medicated. It's for cold sores.
I learned something new today.
You know, we always, in high school, girl, we were hard. And you were like, I got to keep it. No, you need some you need some moisturizer. That's not a moisturizer. No, it's a medicated medicine. So I just let y'all know now.
Yeah, I can testify with that because I don't use it no more because it dried my lips.
That's what it's supposed to do. As you know, as for us, you know, when we have our outbreaks, we want to dry it out. The quicker you dry it out, the quicker it heals.
Exactly.
But that comes with a whole community not being educated.
Yeah, so what is the solution to that? Like getting more education to our children and stuff? Because nowadays you have people, kids younger than, Lord Jesus, are catching STDs. It's like, how do we educate our children and not be, it's like we're so
stigmatized and traditional. We have to, as a community, stop being scared to talk. And my whole thing, the conversations you have in your house is the conversation you have in your house. Nobody know you're talking to your kid about that. Yeah. Many people don't know. Me and my son talk about a lot. We're only nine. He's only nine. And we talk about a lot of stuff. But I tell him, remember, everybody don't feel comfortable with the conversation we're having. So what we have at home, don't feel so comfortable to say it in public. Because some people won't feel comfortable with it. But it doesn't mean what we talked about wasn't valid.
Yeah.
So it's all about, it's a time and place for everything. We know that. That's scripture too. It's a time and place for everything. So we have to understand, just because everybody else don't feel comfortable, that doesn't mean you don't educate.
Yeah.
But we so worried about how everybody feel that we're not educated, and then when it happened, now we got an issue.
Them feelings would get us in so much trouble. We got to get to the point where we get out of our feelings to the point where, because it's like you say, it starts at home. If you're not having this conversation at home, as you're telling your kids about sex, about condoms, about diseases, I talk to my kids about that. You know, everything. They get to the point where, Mom, I don't want to talk about it. Whatever.
Yes, they do, because you're going to talk to your friend anyway.
I'm your mommy. That's why you don't want to talk about it. But we're going to talk about it, because you're going to get it here at home, because in school and stuff, they make it, and even in media, sex sales, so they put it out there so much to the point where, but they're not really educating you about sex. They're just thinking, it's a thing, it's a new norm, but not really educating you, okay, this is how you put a condom on, or...
You know, I don't know. I really want to know, when do a guy learn how to put on a condom? Like, who taught you how to do that? Or did he hand you one and he just said, go for what you know? I ain't going to lie. I'm going to be that mama. My son going to think I'm real, real nasty. But I'm going to say, whip it out. Let's do this. Because at the end of the day, I'm going to give him a dildo in the room. We're going to do this because I don't have time for you to be not. Listen, bro, you're going to have her pregnant if you don't pull the tip off that thing. You're going to be in trouble. You're going to have a baby.
But we do have to we do have to educate our kids, because it's like we get so religious to the point where, you're Christian, but we don't, that's one thing we don't talk about.
How we not talk about that?
It's in the Bible. You know, it's in the Bible, and it's like something that, it's like certain stuff we don't touch at all at church. Like, we don't touch.
You're right.
And I feel like that is really hurting us as a people, as Christians.
As believers, yes.
As believers, that is really hurting us, because we talk about prosperity, we talk about love, we talk
about sickness, healing, all of that.
But we don't talk about sex, and then we talk about HIV, you know, but we don't talk about before it gets to that point. You know,
and that is really where the problem is.
Yeah.
And I think, and I'm going to be, and I'm sure this would be a good conversation for us to have, especially since you're a minister and mm-hmm. things of that nature. Of, I think this is something that I'm noticing as God is kind of leading me into assisting people on this journey of celibacy, because I'm on it myself and struggle like crazy.
Yeah.
As well, is it's not black and white in the Bible. And this is where the Holy Spirit got to kick in. And this is where nobody is really paying attention to the Holy Spirit. Like, you have to get, like, you got to listen to it. Because it's going to give you things that it don't give me. Because mm-hmm. it knows my struggles. But we are looking for a black and white way. And there's no black and white way. He told you what you need to know. He tell you don't do it. Then you need to go ask him why. I need a little bit more understanding. And then he'll lead you back to the scripture with a different translation, which have bust my head open mm-hmm. and helped me to realize, this is why. This is why, because I don't want, this is sinning against your body. And a lot of us, if you get into it, you'll be like, oh, I ain't pay for this body.
Yeah, it's like we don't look at our body as that sacred, mm-mm. sacred jewel. Like,
no.
This is my body. It's like, and so, and it goes to loving yourself.
Yeah, yeah.
Really showing our children how to love their self, their bodies, and how to take care of their self.
Yeah.
You know, that. Self-love is so important, because even when you, you know, do get the diagnosis that you have a SUD, you know, sometimes we feel like we can't love on them. We want nobody to love us, so we ain't gonna love ourselves. So
right.
We fall into addictions. We fall
depression.
Into depression.
Suicidal. Some people take their lives or attempt.
Wow. And because they think their life is over, because we're not educating folks how to love them. So even though if you make the mistake and something bad happens to you, that's where we got to get to the point. We have to show people how to love themselves.
Yeah.
Because there's still love after you get a disease. There's still love there.
Oh,
there's
yeah.
Love
and
yourself.
You know, many people got love. Listen, tell this y'all, I ain't have no problem. I ain't have no problem. Listen.
Me either.
No, but
no
it took
problem.
Me, and once again, just go back to scripture again.
Yeah.
We got to love ourselves to love others. And I think that's what makes it hard, where a lot of us are coming from a place of lack of. And then you wonder why you keep dragging in lack of, mm-hmm. because that's what you are.
Yeah.
And we don't like to hear it. That's what the world say. Well, you attract what you are. No, you attracting the lack of love that you have for yourself. That's
exactly.
just it. And I think it's just a gut punch to feel that, man, I don't love myself. That's why I keep attracting men like that or women like that. And it's a like, why though? And then when it get to the why piece, that's why we struggle, because nobody really help you get to the root of why you having a problem.
Why?
Because if I keep meeting guys who talk to me any type of way, I got to ask myself why. Now I got to pull all the way back. Let's go back to childhood, and everybody gets sick of this, but it's the truth. Go back to your childhood and find out who talked to you crazy. and you had to allow them to talk to you crazy, because sometimes it was your mama. Sometimes it was your uncles. It was sometimes it was, you know, people around you where you didn't have the control. You had to suck it up. And then you get with somebody, you were like, well, that's my type of love, because that's what I received. They took care of me. And sadly say, sometimes he talking to you crazy, but he take good care of you. So you assuming that just comes with it, but we got to understand that love is a learned behavior, and if you want to learn it, you got to learn it a different way if you want it differently, you know. But sometimes it just takes some time to unlearn, and we just got to be patient with ourselves with unlearning stuff. The mind is a powerful thing, y'all.
Ooh, and I was just reading about the mind, you know. I watched a YouTube channel, and she was talking about good ground. And she was talking about the brain. It's on YouTube. This young lady, she was on T.D. Jakes.
It was
T.D. Jakes Church. And she was minister about, she's a mental illness. She's a psychiatrist.
Okay.
So she specializes in mental illness. And she was talking about how the brain, how the mind itself is a plant. It's a seed.
Mm-hmm.
But if the picture that she showed a seed, the root of a seed, and how the seed was in the ground. And she showed the brain of the brain and the seed.
And it do this.
No, they both was exactly the same.
Yep.
Exactly the same. And we got to get to the point where our mind is a powerful tool.
Mm-hmm.
Very powerful tool, to the point where even getting a diagnosis, even it can switch your mind to the point where, like you said, you kill yourself.
Yeah. I tell people, and there's something I learned with herpes is mental. more than it is physical for us. And that's why I'm in school for traumatology to get my doctorate, because we can't look at herpes as a STI, because they don't really look at herpes as STI. This is the reason why I tell you. They don't test us for it. You know why? Because it's not a reportable STD. The reportable STDs is gonorrhea, chlamydia, syphilis, trichomoniasis, and HIV. Okay? And Hep C.
Where do you think that the history of herpes? Because I know the history of HIV.
History of herpes, they say it started back in the day. But now, let me tell y'all, if y'all do some research, half of the herpes stuff going to come up off of animals. Just to get y'all some
HIV
info.
HIV too?
So, with that being said, guys, we got to understand, we did eat animals a lot, like back in the day.
That's where the diseases come from.
we can't deny back in the day we eat unclean animals, you know. We didn't know any better. We were just eating these things, you know. Yep, animals were being sacrificed. Some people was having sex with animals. We just got to keep it real. Mm-hmm. You know, that was their culture, so we can't deny it, not as an ill thing, but more of a keeping it real. So we got to understand that if you look up herpes, it's over 200 and something just with animals alone.
Wow.
It's just only 9, quote unquote, between 8 and 9 that affect humans.
Wow.
So.
And I can agree with that, because when I did the history of HIV, HIV came from chick bees. It came from the monkeys.
Yeah, absolutely.
Came from that. Came from when they was eating them and they was having, you know, doing their thing, and they would. That's where the strain, HIV strain, come from. But that's a good point. We got to know the history and the root to anything, and so we can, like I said, educate. It's all about education. But on that note, I'm gonna go into a break, and I'm gonna play my first song, Poker Jones, "Love Thyself." Okay.
That was good.
That was good.
Yeah, girl, you did that. Oh, that was good. You know me, I'm going
to
be me.
Yeah, I want to be you. I want to tell the truth, too, you know.
We ain't got time to be playing no more.
Exactly.
We in a season where you better keep it real, because I ain't got time. The enemy ain't playing. Y'all better not play either.
Yeah, he is not playing. He is not playing. And it was like we... Now see, well, I'm gonna come back on this.
Yeah, where you gonna lead us to? Because I think we did good with that one.
Yeah. Okay, we're gonna come back and talk to those who do have it.
Okay.
Give them some ways to deal with it. If even mentally,
physically,
wherever, however you want.
Okay,
it.
I got you.
Yeah.
Good. Cool. Okay, that's good. Got it. Got it. Got it. Good. I feel like I know him from somewhere, but I don't know where. I don't know where I seen him at.
His dress.
I don't know. I'm talking about I seen him somewhere. I don't know. It's a small world, man.
Yes, it is. You
the world is really tiny. And yeah, I feel like I seen him at another studio.
You know, some people just you. Yeah, walk past and you.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's
that mind. That mind lets you remember some things. You're like, I seen you before.
Girl, that mind is.
I ain't gonna lie. I don't have seen people in my dream, and I seen them. I said, I know you.
Mm-hmm.
I know you. And they was like, you look familiar too. And I said, I tell people, I said, God do things for a reason.
Yeah.
I feel like sometimes he do that to let you know you're in the right place. Like you're going in the path I want you to go in.
Yeah, because I have dreams of people that I haven't even talked for a long time, and then automatically I just dreamed them. You know? And I just pray for them and whatever, because I'd be like, look, I don't want to even think about you.
That was random, right?
Why did I dream about you?
Come back on.
That was Pokey Jones, "Love Thyself." That was my first time hearing that song. I was like, ooh, I got to get that song. Be up to Pokey Jones, "Love Thyself," the Soul King. If you listening out there, make sure y'all purchase that song on YouTube. Get with him. He's doing some great things for the kingdom, and be up to him. I just had to have that song in my lineup tonight. And on that note, we're going to go and get some health checks, you know, helping out some people out there that are dealing with this herpes that, you know, herpes that everybody's scared to talk about or scared to touch, you know. But we're going to help those who out there who is dealing with it, because it is a lot of people that don't talk about it.
Mm-mm.
They're afraid to talk about it because of people being judgmental or people looking down on them or whatever. At the same moment, that herpes don't change who you are. You
Not
know,
at all.
It's just something that you have. It doesn't change the person that God is creating you to be. It's just, to me, you know, it just, like you said, you know, you can, God give you free will to sin, but you can't, the consequence, you can't pick, but what's the consequence going to be? And, you know, and sometimes the consequence is you do get something that you don't want when you go out there and you sin or you fornicate. We're just going to call it what it is. When you go and fornicate and you're not married, and this is what things, some things happen. You know, some people, unfortunately, they don't get it. Something else happened too, but at the end of the day, you know, you fell, you messed up, you got to get up and you got to keep it moving. Keep it moving, because God bless you to see another day, because you could have died. And so we're going to just help those out there who are dealing with this disease.
Yeah.
Get them some little help, some little love, some encouragement.
Yeah, absolutely. So I really want my individuals, number one, who are living with herpes, just got newly diagnosed, and old diagnosed. I want you to know, number one, you're not by yourself. You're listening to two people who literally had the same situation. Like, literally, we both had, well, she was already pregnant. I ended up getting pregnant literally a year, going to a year, almost close to the date that I found out my diagnosis, I had my son. So I want you to know you have people who get it. And I want you to understand, the people you look at every day, it's a chance. One out of two, one out of three, somebody in this room got it.
Mm-hmm.
And interesting, it's four of us. So two of us got it in the room. You know, so with that being said, I really want you guys to understand, it's just that common. Sorry. It's just that common. And you don't have to have, you know, a lot of people, especially for us, thinking, do I have to have an outbreak? No. Like, I really want us to kill that within our own community, that you think, oh, I got to have this outbreak, or is my outbreak as bad as hers? Or sadly to say, I learned we compare too much, especially in this community. We compare absolutely too much. Yeah. And you have to really, in herpes, it make you be you. Mm-hmm. It make you focus on you, and it make you close your eyes, put your blinders on, or if you go keep your eyes on, keep your blinders on, not to worry about nobody else. That's because right. Your story is going to be completely different. Mm-hmm. The only thing that's the same is herpes.
Yep.
Nothing else the same. Our outbreaks, how they look, how they feel, yeah. Your treatment plan, how you disclose, yeah. How you accept it, yeah. How you deal with friends and family, it's all different. So I really want us to understand is, number one, you don't have to have outbreaks. It's not a requirement. It's not like any other thing, like gonorrhea, chlamydia. You got to remember, some of those are silent. You won't even know it, or it goes unnoticed. Mm-hmm. So I really want us to understand that it could be anything. And I kind of want to get into that, because some people always ask me, that's one of my main questions, what are the symptoms, Belize? I have it, but I don't know what to expect because I'm looking for it.
Yeah.
So it can be itching. I mean, simple itching, y'all. I'm talking about, like, you know, for guys, jock itch, or women, yeast infections, to give y'all a more vivid picture. So it could be like that. It could be discharge for some women. Yeah, they say it's no discharge. They are not telling the truth. Yes, it can be. Okay. It could be discharge. And it has a weird smell, too. It's not typical, like bacterial vaginosis or yeast infection or any. It's just something that you know ain't right.
That's right.
Okay. And this is important for women to know, what do she smell like when it's not on, and when it smell like... Ladies, please look at it. Like, I'm sorry.
You got to learn your body.
Listen, it's nothing wrong with knowing what it looked like when and without. Because if you don't know, how are you going to protect anybody?
Exactly.
Okay? And that's a whole other situation. Mm-hmm. But you can have discharge. Okay? So that is something that can happen. Also, cuts, bumps, blisters. It don't have to open up, so it can look like a simple pimple. It can look like a razor bump. Oh, that happens. So many people thinking it's a razor bump. Some people think it's a boil. It's not a boil. So I really want us to understand is, it can look like many things that we look at on a daily. And you're like, well, it don't hurt. It don't have to hurt. Let us stop looking at Google and saying it hurt automatically. It do not have to hurt. Everybody's not suffering. Like, everybody's not suffering. Some people, literally, it's so small, they don't realize it. It be the itching that's unbearable. It be the aching. That's another thing. Some people have, like, really achy legs. Mm-hmm. Some people get headaches.
Abdominal pain.
Come on. Some people get their back hurt real bad. Some people butts like be stinging or they have like tingling all over their body. Y'all know, or sticky in your feet. You know, like you step down hard, you can feel it in your feet. Let me tell you why you have these nerve pains. It is on your nerve endings.
Yep.
This is why this virus is so freaking tricky, because at the end of the day, it hides in the nerve. That means if I kill the virus, I kill the nerve. If I kill the nerve, I kill the brain. Like, it's just, we got to understand why this is so tricky for them to want to touch, because it affects the nervous system. And as we know, our nervous system is nothing but our feelings, our emotions. And this is where it gets, this kind of shifts us into where herpes is really controlled based off your psychological health. And a lot of us, whacked. We are so whacked. Not because we want to be. It's just because nobody taught us how important mental health was. As we grew up, we only learned what was given to us. A lot of us, even though it may have been healthy, it was still detrimental. Some things that happened, you could have been a two-parent household, you could have been a one, but still things that you experienced still was traumatic. And you never was able to talk about it or learn how to communicate through it or how to process it. And as we know, as you grow up, you're nothing but little kids in a grown person body. So with that being said, this virus, honey, that's a whole nother conversation for a whole nother day. Okay, so... with this virus, stress is our number one trigger, y'all.
Yes,
like,
it
will whoop your tail. Especially women, get out your feelings. Get a journal, pray. I know, but I'm talking about, I got to talk for me, because that's what I am. I can only speak for myself. I ain't going to speak on my brothers, but I can speak for us. That
I still love y'all, though.
Yes. I know, they be emotional. I love them, though. But at the end of the day, we have to understand that We can't worry. And as God tells us, cast our cares. This is why, because he knows stress kill you. Literally. It's not the virus that'll take you out. It's the stress that will. And I don't...
the virus.
Listen, I want y'all to really do some research on stress. It's like three types of forms of stress. And you will be mind blown where you lie. And some of us think, I'm not stressed. I don't feel stressed. But your body will tell you. Lack of sleep. You know, like if you're tired, if you feel fatigued, if you always hungry, if you always thirsty. It's something wrong with you. You ain't hungry. You ain't thirsty. You know you eat. You know you. Now, if you ain't drinking water, I'm going to get on y'all. Drink y'all water. But, you know, but still, it affects the body. It shuts the body down. Or keep the body up where the mind is still racing. So stress is the main thing for us. Going into the symptoms as well. So we just got to make sure we understand that herpes can look different on everybody.
Yeah.
Don't look for it to look the same. You just got to learn your body.
I agree with that, because when I was done, you know, when I found out I had herpes or whatever, I didn't know how. I had to learn my body. You know, what was, you know, giving me these outbreaks, because I used to get them a lot, like once a month. I just knew I was going to have an outbreak. Now I very seldom get outbreaks. Thank God for that, because that is very painful. But
mine are painful too.
I learned how to. And stress is the number one factor of it. You know, I was stressing so much at that time, you know, pregnant and, life happens. And I really had to learn your eating, the way that your diet. Is very, it will cause an outbreak as well. If we don't, if something about that food, we have to really have to learn on the importance of the benefits of food and for our bodies.
It's to fuel you, not to just satisfy you. It's to fuel you.
No, not at all. And so I had to learn how to, I had to change my diet, the way I ate. Even when I was exercising, now that I exercise so much, I don't get outbreaks at all. But when I started really just exercising, I used to get it, because the stress that was on my nervous system.